Morning Richmond High. Today is Monday, November 16th, and my name is Stephanie.
Y mi nombre es Jessica Contreras.
And we are here to bring you the Richmond High weekly news. Last week, our inner club council, teachers and admin, helped create a quarter one survey to hear from students. Please take some time to fill it out and let us know how school has been for you. We know there has been a lot of changes. Let us know how we can best support you. Ask your homeroom teacher for the link.
La semana pasada, nuestro consejo interclub, profesores y administradores ayudaron a crear una encuesta del primer trimestre para escuchar de nuestros estudiantes. Por favor, tómate un tiempo para llenarlo y hacernos saber cómo podemos ayudarte lo mejor posible. Pídele el enlace Zoom a tu maestro de homeroom.
We've got a few announcements for seniors. First, if you need help with any part of your college apps, please join Miss Edith on Mondays and Fridays from 9:30 to 10 a.m. or 3 to 3:30 p.m. Find her Zoom at this link right here. Second, if you received a D or F for quarter one and need to enroll in Ingenuity to make up your credits, complete the Ingenuity interest form to sign up. And last, senior portraits are December 7th and 8th. You'll be getting an email soon with your appointment time.
Tenemos anuncios para los seniors. En primer lugar, si necesitas ayuda con cualquier parte de tus aplicaciones universitarias, únete a la señora Edith los lunes y los viernes de 9:30 a 10 o de 3 a 3:30. Este es el Zoom link. En segundo lugar, si recibiste una D o F para el primer trimestre y necesitas inscribirte a Ingenuity para compensar los créditos, completa su formulario. Aquí está el link para registrarte. Y por último, los retratos de seniors son del 7 al 8 de diciembre. Recibirás un correo electrónico pronto con la hora de tu cita.
Shout out to the RHS football and cheerleading that have been conditioning and practicing on campus. Fall sports including football, cheerleading, tennis, cross country, girls volleyball will start their official seasons on December 7th. Contact Coach Hudson if you want to get involved.
Un reconocimiento especial al equipo de football y porristas de RHS porque han estado haciendo acondicionamiento y practicando en el campus. Los deportes de otoño incluyendo football, porristas, tennis, cross country y voleibol femenino empiezan oficialmente su temporada este 7 de diciembre. Comuníquese con el entrenador Hudson si desea participar.
One last reminder, there is no school next week. This is our last week of school before we go on a week-long break. Do your best to attend your classes, be in touch with your teachers, and stay on top of your work so you can relax and rest during your break.
Un último recordatorio. No hay escuela la próxima semana. Esta es nuestra última semana antes de entrar al break de una semana. Hagan todo lo posible para asistir a sus clases, estar en contacto con sus profesores, y estar al tanto de su trabajo para que puedan descansar y relajarse durante nuestro break.
That's all we have for announcements today. Coming right up, take a look at what our students are up to during distance learning.
Woman that inspires me, I would say, would be Emma Watson, because she started her career at a very young age and still decided to go to college even though she was already famous. And she advocates for woman empowerment and gender equality.
Inspiration to me is definitely my aunt, considering she's trans, especially in the Latin community. Back at home, it was a really nice change of pace. They didn't know what that was, so when they found out, it was kind of a strange idea, but she really opened their minds and changed a lot of opinions with that, and I really aspire and hope to do that someday with a community of my own. It could be my family, it could be anyone really, but I just want to inspire people and do the same thing, and whatever idea, if it's opening them up to the LGBT, if it's changing someone's mind on reproductive rights, anything really.
Hi, I'm Valamia Parker, and a woman that inspires me is Ariana Grande. The reason why she inspires me is because, one, from all the dramas and scandals that she went through, she actually built up from it, and, you know, she learned from her past mistakes and her failures. And look what she's got going on now. She's actually succeeding. So yeah, I hope to be like her one day. So yeah, that's a woman that inspires me.
Leaving behind nights of terror and fear, I rise. Into a daybreak that wondrously clear, I rise. Bringing the gifts that my ancestors gave, I am the dream and the hope of the slave. I rise, I rise, I rise. Still I rise, Maya Angelou.
Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring, ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicings rise high as the listening sky. Now I'm gonna sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Said I'm gonna sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. I'm gonna sing a song, yeah. I'm gonna lift my voice. Facing the rising sun of a new day begun, let us march on till victory is won.
Lift every BSU is alive and well at RHS. However, we still need a lot more voices and participation of our Black youth. BSU meets Tuesdays at 3:15. Here's the Google Classroom code. Here's the Zoom info and password. All are welcome, but this club is specifically designed to support our Black youth academically, emotionally, and to be sure that their voices are heard and represented. We are not able to make this club into what you would like to see unless we have your input, participation, and voice. For additional info, contact Mr. Wilson, Ms. Brown, or Mr. Bencoli.
That's our show for today. Tune in next week for Richmond High Weekly News. Bye, Richmond High.
Seniors applying to four-year universities, please make sure to have your applications reviewed before you submit. You can sign up for app review during our college app workshops or by appointment at https://2021appreview.
The College and Career Center programs are still enrolling new students. Once you review your options, go to the link provided to complete the interest form to start the enrollment process.
I choose selectivity because I want to know which ones are like the best for me, and like also to make sure depending on what I want to do. And another one, it's like also I choose majors because I want to be like 100% sure about what I want to do and pick the careers I want to pursue. For the second question, what did you find out through your research? By making some research, I would say location, because I actually don't want to go far away from here. And yeah.
Hi. So the first category I chose was a major because it keeps you on the right track and it also prepares you more for the future. And I also chose paying because I want to make sure I can afford what I want to study at and also make sure I can afford the things I may need. What I found out is for majors, they are actually teaching you the more important things that may come in handy for the future. And for pricing, it depends on the location for where you want, for where I want to study at.
Okay, so hi. Today I'm going to be answering two questions. Why did you choose those categories to focus on? The two categories I chose to focus on were the major and the eligibility I had because, I mean, first off, the major, because I just don't want to go into any other, like, college. That doesn't have the major that I want to do because, I mean, the major matters to me. I just don't want to do something random. And the selectability, because that is going to help me to know, like, which ones would be better for me and which ones would be like easier for me to get into and I wouldn't like struggle a lot basically. And the other question is, what did you find through your research that could help? I mean, what would help would be also a location, because I mean, I don't want to go far, but I want to stay nearby. And one another thing that could help would be the financial part, because I mean, that would help me know if I ever needed like a scholarship or anything like that to help me get into a college, even though it could be a community college or anything.
Not only was the president elected, but city council members in Richmond and San Pablo were too. Let's learn about them. Gail McLaughlin believes that Richmond deserves to be a safe, healthy, sustainable, and just city. Claudia Jimenez has experience on making neighborhoods safe, clean, and kid-friendly with the support of the community itself. Melvin Lee Willis Jr. strongly believes Richmond can be a place where we can all come together and increase in community participation. In San Pablo, Patricia Ponce continues to be involved in her neighborhood school and wants to work together for better quality of life. Abel Pineda, the youngest member, wants to be sure we youth receive better opportunities and resources. Finally, the current mayor of San Pablo is welcoming to any concerns and will continue to work for change.
That's our show for today. Tune in next week for your Richmond High Weekly News. And don't forget to stream POV from Ariana Grande's new album, Positions. Bye, Richmond High.
Adios, Richmond High.